You want to talk about rust. The Islanders had 9 days without a game, 8 days without a practice, but go back farther than that. Thomas Greiss hadn't played in 14 days, and he posts back-to-back shutouts now.
I guess he doesn't know what rust means. I mean, he was great. I mean, that's back-to-back shutouts, as you mentioned, and it's about the big saves at the right time, and he had plenty of those, and this was early on in the game with Braden Point, that is, getting a point-blank opportunity, and then this save close in by Gord, another big save. But, I mean, just Thomas Greiss is just, you can see that even though he hasn't been playing, he's got the good rhythm. So, you know, when he's having his practices, he's working hard. He must have been doing some things off ice during the break, not just sunshine and all fun. He was thinking about his game, probably maybe figuring he was going to start the season off again. So he was great, and you're right, Brendan. Neither one of these goaltenders should lose the game in a shootout. Neither one of these games goalies deserve to lose, period.
It's a 41-save shutout for Greiss. It goes some 146 minutes and 48 seconds without a goal. And then Andre Vasilevsky, 36-save shutout. Again, the Islanders, if you want to talk about a one negative here, Butch, it's that they had opportunities with the power play to win this hockey game, especially in overtime.
Well, that was the difference maker, really, in the end of the night. I mean, they had five on fours during the game, and then they had the four on three in the overtime. And so often we talk about that. The teams that can score on their power play and take advantage of it, get a lead, protect the lead, you know, they're going to win hockey games. So the Islander power play has been inconsistent all year long, and Barry Trotz and Lou Lamoriello, they don't talk about the power play. They say, you know, can it score a goal when we needed it? Well, it couldn't tonight.
It's the third time in Islanders history that the only goal of the game has come in a shootout. The Islanders had won their previous two. They lose this one. And you want to talk about a guy like Anders Lee, and we saw him really from the first shift of the hockey game. Anders Lee, Jordan Eberle, Brock Nelson, their line, the best line for the Islanders tonight.
The whole line was really good, but Anders Lee in particular, probably his best game maybe in the last little while. I mean, he was on his toes early on, and we talk about being ready and being a leader by example. I mean, this guy was all over the place. I mean, he was on the puck. He was jumping in and out of holes. He was winning battles in the corners. He had opportunities himself to score. But, I mean, he played his game, and he was ready to play. And that's what you need from your captain. You need it from everybody else. So you want to get your team off on the right foot. Anders Lee certainly did his part, and just a tremendous game. Along with his two line mates, it wasn't all about him, but he certainly was the leader.
No Islander had more than Anders Lee's six shots. And since he didn't add to his point totals, 50 games, 18 goals, 19 assists. He leads the Islanders in goals. Well, I mentioned this at the end of overtime that I didn't want to see a shootout because some games, I mean, this one should have ended in a tie. I mean, I'm all for the shootout and to get a winner, but tonight it just felt like we didn't want to see a shootout. We did see one in the Islanders. That's another problem for them. They've scored three shootout goals all year in seven different shootouts. That's an issue.
Yeah, they just haven't been good in the shootouts, and they haven't looked good. It's not like the goaltenders have had to make spectacular saves. I mean, they just had to make a couple of saves. And this one here, Hedman knew exactly where he's going. I thought Thomas Greiss was out far enough, but the Islanders just didn't get enough done in their shootouts. I mean, there's no faking. I mean, and perhaps I'm a little too critical, but I was pretty good on breakaways, and I do understand that, you know, as a forward trying to go in on a goaltender, you have got to give that goaltender something to think about. You've got to have a couple of fakes, you know, whether it's a head fake, shoulder fakes, or even, you know, fake shooting the puck. But the Islanders, for me, are too easy as far as the shootout's concerned. They go in, they're one-dimensional, and they're not getting a lot of results. So, you know, this is an area where they need to be a whole lot more proficient, because these are big points, and at least you want to have the goaltenders come up with big 10-bell saves, and right now the opposition's making it look easy.
Islanders have lost back-to-back games now, but in this shootout loss, they extended their overall point streak to seven games. Still an impressive run for the Islanders, and when the Islanders beat the Lightning back on January 13th, we talked about it being a statement win. This was kind of a message-sending game to the rest of the league, that the Islanders, we're after the All-Star break. They took a few days off, but they're still rolling.
Well, absolutely. I mean, if you're wondering, you know, are the Islanders going to be able to get this done in sort of the second half of the season? Well, yeah, they clearly are ready to play, and they're real, because, again, this was not a bottom-place team. This is the team with the best record in the entire National Hockey League, had an edge in conditioning or an edge in maybe finesse to start this game. And the Islanders, for in my money, were step-to-step, stride-to-stride. side and had some great opportunities and could have easily won this game. I mean, either side could have won this game. It was that close. But certainly, I think this is a pretty good statement to the rest of the league that these guys are for real, and you want to play against them, it's going to be tough. As a matter of fact, I was talking to one of the scouts in the crowd today, and they were like amazed at what's going on with this organization as far as the structure of this team and how difficult they are to play against. So the Islanders are playing their game, and they're being successful.
And it was a whole lot of fun to watch.
It really was. It was maybe the best game of the season, Brendan, from my perspective. I really enjoyed it. It was a playoff game. It's you could feel the intensity. The fans were on the edge of their seat, and the anticipation, the hope that the Islanders were going to score a goal. So just a tremendous effort, just a great game.